Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Impromptu Coffee and Art in the Afternoon. I'm Dee Dee. And so it's a Sunday afternoon, so I thought I would just go ahead and do a stream that I want to throw some dilutions in my new journal. Now, y'all know the other one is pretty much full, even though I want to finish it. But anyway, I was working on this picture of Sean Connery. I was saying before I hit record that Hubster wanted me to draw a couple. He's big into old movies, loves old movies. And yesterday there was a James Bond on, and he said, you need to draw me some pictures of some of the old stars, because he likes John Wayne, Robert Mitchum, Clint Eastwood. Who else did I sketch out? Lee Marvin. Anyway, so I sketched all them out. But when I came across this great picture of Sean Connery close up, and this is actually how big the photograph is that I found, I said, I want to do that for myself. So he was heading out this afternoon, and he said, oh, what are you working on? Are you working on Robert Mitchum, Lee Marvin? Which one are you working on? I went, nothing. I see me. And he goes, you're working on Sean, aren't you? I said, maybe. So anyway, yeah, I'm working on Sean first, but he's got a glowy bronzy tan in this picture. So I'm going to have to, you know, really work on getting that glow tan. So he's just kind of base coated in. And like I said, because it was just this picture this big, I went ahead and put a little doodly frame around him like this. So anyway, so I'm kind of working on that one. Okay, so, but what I was going to stream, thanks everybody for stopping in. I watched Paula's recording. I'm behind on a lot of recordings, you know, with doing stuff for the cheer and that came in. The moms and the girls stopped by here on their way to Florida Friday, and which was nice. And so they'll probably stop back here tomorrow evening, is probably, because from my house it's probably about a 7-hour drive. From their house it's like an 8.5 hours, so they'll probably stop here on their way all the way through Atlanta, because they live North Atlanta. So anyway, that being said, I've only watched Paula's, and I love that. And when Paula said something like, what was it, I wrote it down, I tweeted it earlier, she said boo-hoo, not, was it not boohoo? Who? Ho, ho, ho. She said something like, ho, ho, or something like that. She said, where'd that come from? I never said ho, ho before. I think that's what it was. I think it was ho, ho. She goes, where did that come from? I just cracked up. So this morning on Twitter, I went, ho, ho, Paula. So now it's going to be, you know what I mean, Vern? Ho, ho. And then I thought she was going to bust out in the song, but she didn't. Okay, so anyway, this is always here for, this is always here for camera folks. Now my eyes are watering. I can't even see the chat because my eyes are watering from laughing. Hang on. Oh, wait, that's Denise. Hang on. Awards are starting soon. Okay, hang on, guys. Let me text her and say, let me tell her, keep me posted. Because then what you have to do at these events is usually you don't get very good service inside the convention centers. You have to like go either to the door or outside the door to get, you know, to tweet or to message or whatever. So she probably ran outside real quick, messaged, and ran back in. So that's what I'm thinking she's doing, because that's what we've had to do before. Yes, we are live. We are live and not Memorex, Sandy Chick. Anyway, it was so funny that I was really almost literally rolling on the floor laughing. Okay, so I moved the camera. Now we're about a foot and a half instead of like 8 inches off the table, because when I do drawings, I'm trying to perfect how to do those close-up drawings with the light coming this way and all that, when it's, you know, to see detail. But since I'm not drawing right now, I moved the camera up, but I still have it on a tripod right here. Hubster got me this long-armed tripod that I can hook the camera to and adjust the arm, and it has all, you know, all that. So I don't have the big floor tripod with the big stick hanging over my head, which is what I've always used up until a few months ago when he got this one. The only problem is the legs of the tripod are literally right there, right there. And so if I do anything too big, I have to either tuck it up under that, which is what I'm getting ready to do, or whatever. But first off, I got all my pencils here because, like I said, I'm working on a drawing of somebody I really like. Anyway, so I'm going to just pick up all my pencils here and put them in my pencil drawer right now, along with my erasers, my paint brushes that I'm using. So this is all the stuff that I've been using for my portraits the last few weeks. And so I just keep it in this drawer here just because it's easier to carry around and move around from my desk, you know, to off the desk to another room if I want or whatever. Let me move my Sharpies over there. My water brush doesn't need to go in there. Okay, so let me just move that off here. Oh, Jeannie, are you here? I bought a couple books yesterday. You want to see? Oh, and this. yeah, I got a couple of books yesterday. Hey, Linda. Everybody else popping in. Hi, E.T. Oh, let me allow links and all that. I don't think we... let me mod somebody, too. Where's Eileen? Let's mod Eileen. Eileen's got the boot. Let me get back to the people. So thanks, everybody, for popping in. A couple people I don't know, welcome. Thanks for being here. I know it's most of the time I stream 9 a.m. during the weekdays. So, you know, we've got a different crew in the mornings. If anyone needs... Thanks, Eileen. Yeah. Okay, so what I want to do... let me get my other books just to refresh. Not that anybody hasn't seen it 100 times, but you know, hey. All right, let's see. Got a couple of magazine images I want to use, some flowers in the back here. Got a few things stuck back here that I'm going to want to use. Okay, so what I thought I would do is I got a new one, I think it was for Christmas. Another Dilutions. It's the exact same one as this, but you couldn't tell how from the size. This is all puffed up. It's gotten fluffy. So this is what it looks like when it's new. This is what it looks like after anybody that does mixed media gets a hold of one of these. So what I'm going to do is I am going to go into the new one and I'm going to try and smack and drag every page in here with Dilutions ink. Okay. And then just let it, you know, either air dry or heat gun it. I don't know yet because I don't know if I'm going to work in it after I do that. I'm going to be just like totally like that's enough for me today. But I'm going to do all the pages. I think there's about 100. I think. I don't remember, but we're going to find out. So we're going to do that. So this is what the journal looks like when it starts getting fluffy. This holds up really well. The only thing is, and this is true if you're doing a magazine journal or any kind of journal, that if you don't care if it's in order, then you should go front to back to front to back. Otherwise, your spine starts warping like this, where if you start in the front, then do the back, then front and back. And if you go back and forth in your pages, you won't get this happening to your... Let me see if I can grab one of my magazine journals. I got a couple of them right here. Let's see, actually I have three of them. Let me pull these three. Okay, so, well, let me just get these two, because that has the best example. So, these are magazine journals. I've taken two, they're not Somerset Studios, but they're art magazines, Stampington and, you know, Blog or something. I forget which ones they even were. They're not my Somersets, and they're not my art journal ones, but they're other publications that are by Stampington. They're art magazines, and I glued two of them together and then play in them. So here you can see the difference, and still even did a little on this one. Here's one where I just went straight from front to back. and you see what happened to the spine. There's two magazines glued together. But this is what happens if you don't go front to back, front to back. Here's one where I went front to back, and it still warped it a little, but not as badly as just going straight through. So these are just magazines glued together and then played in, journaled in, colored in. I think this one has more cooler stuff than this one. And then I just covered that. What I do is I glue the front and back covers of two of them together, and then I cover them with a scrapbook paper, and I either, in this case, I duct taped this one. In this case, I just did packing tape, clear packing tape. And then you can play in it. You can do reverse collage. You can just do whatever. What I liked about it is what I practice, and this is what I, the last time I showed this, is I was telling my viewers to practice colors with this kind of thing. Take an image. Now, this has been glued in. I have glued in some things. But take, okay, here's a good example. Take, no, that's not a good one either. It's not enough color. Let me find one with a lot of color. Let's see. Well, this is kind of good. You take the images that are on the page, and you try to incorporate those colors with your paints, your inks, whatever. So using like the teal, the yellow ochre, some of the orange, then you play with the colors that are on those images while you're like reverse collaging out everything you don't want. And it's just for a place to play. You can make this into an actual journal with, you know, with a big pen over acrylic paint. You don't, Sharpies and all that won't really last. But anyway, so it's just a way to, see if I can find a few more. Here's another one where you can just play with the colors. I don't know. It's fun for me. I enjoy it every now and then when you just want to throw some paint down and you don't really want to think about it. You know, you just want to play with some paint. So that's the reason I brought that out, though, is to show you the spines that you want to go from back to front, back to front, back to front, if you want to make these kind of journals, or even if it's just a plain journal, you want to try not to just go straight from front to back because it will warp the spine. All right, let me throw this back up on the shelf here. Oh, here's one of these little journals. Forgot I had this one. Huh. I found another little mini journal I forgot I had. Sorry. Rabbit trail. Okay. So this one, I started just doing collages. Actually, let me tell you the story of this one. When I first got this one, I was going to do it all in calligraphy, a calligraphy journal, because it had nice thick pages and, you know, it was pretty, you know, good. I thought I would just, well, so I did my initials on the front page, and I decided I didn't want to do it in calligraphy. So it turned out to be just a mixed media, and if you'll see a shine because I did varnish most of these. The ones that are finished, I have varnished. And I use, and I know I repeat myself, but you know, different people at different times need to, you know, I don't want to not ignore anybody's questions. It's the Delta Ceram Coat Gloss Exterior Interior Varnish. And this size jar cost at Hobby Lobby, it was $10.38, but of course you use a 40 or 50% off. No, I really don't. I kind of date the book. Sometimes, well, I should say sometimes, Jean. In my, in a couple of the newer ones I have, I have dated them because I don't get to them as often. But like this one, I thought I would just work straight through in about 6 months. And as you saw, I started in 2013 and it's not done yet. But yeah, that is a good thing to do, is date your pages. Now I date, you know, I put a year on things, but I don't usually, well, I say sometimes I do. So when you use this And I did test it out in this particular journal because I had never varnished any of my art journal pages before. So I tested it out in this, Linda, in this book, I tested it out. If y'all are watching the recording, this is a live chat with live people. And so I'm talking to people in the chat. So if you just want to get to the meat of whatever I'm doing, just fast forward. It's okay. Just ignore the chat and fast forward. So anyway, this I wanted to test it out to see if they would stick. So I did one page at a time and let it dry overnight and closed it up for like a few days and it did not stick. Mind you, I said it was perfectly dry before I closed it. So you want to leave each page open at least I would say at least 4 or 5 hours to make sure it's perfectly dry. So these are just the pages that I've done in this journal that is not finished yet. Let me see if I can kind of let me prop this side up so a little bit of the glare. Get something over here to prop it up just to keep the lamp glare off there. That's a little better. So it is, these are all pages that are been varnished and are finished. And it turned out that it just seemed like they were all had black backgrounds in this case, or most of them had black backgrounds or dark backgrounds. So I just went with it. I just went with the whole, darker color backgrounds in this one. So you can see the pages are not sticking. Now they might have a couple of little places where right in the spine, see that one's like right in the spine, you can hear it kind of but the varnish does not stick. So I was really happy with that. And if they're not varnished, they're not done. I use this one. I kept this one on my cell phone for a long time as my home page. But so just to kind of give y'all a quick little peruse through this one. This one is not varnished. It's not done. I really like the way this one turned out. So they're mixed media, collage, paint. This one's not done. So maybe some of the rest of these may not be done. Yeah, so you can see they're in different stages. So I have the rest of the book is in different stages, and I am determined to finish it eventually. All right, so there we go. There's that one, and let me stack up all my little bowls again. And so what I want to do though is this one I want to be more colorful and more yeah, that's what I was just saying, Susan. It's not sticky. Yeah, this brand right here. Okay, so let me take this and put it back on the shelf. I have been working in my I have my idea journal, my idea notebook. This is my idea notebook, which I will still kind of cover some more things that I'm doing in it if I see a real interest. But and then I put back some of my pages that were like all over the place that are just play pages. These are like some jelly plated, some random just excess stuff. And so this is like a good one for me to brayer off jelly plating and all that. All right, so what I wanted to do with this one, brand new, still haven't used it. I got it for Christmas. You can see it's just pure and pristine. Is I want to do the smack and drag with the dilutions inks on all the pages for a base coat. Okay, so and excuse the squeaky chair, guys. It's still my same old chair. So I have one of these big, one of these quilting cutting things, which I never use for sewing. I bought it strictly for a cutting mat and for the backside as an inking mat. Now what I'll do, I know there's a glare from my overhead lamp. I don't really need a lot of light for that, so I'll just turn off that overhead light while I'm doing this part. But I'm going to lift up my, hang on, because I'm gonna lift up the camera legs just to tuck that up under there. Hopefully this isn't gonna go flying anywhere as we work on it. Okay, so, and then this is for my camera focus right there. All right, so let me just look at chat real quick. Let me put this down just a tad. See, there's my, you can see my tripod legs right there. I just stuck this up under there. But this will be up plenty of room for me to use to smack and drag all the pages of this book. Okay, so, all right, shove this over. All right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my dilutions, and I keep them in these little, sorry, Paula, but I keep them in these little Kleenex boxes. Ho-ho! Sorry, if you didn't watch Paula's show last night, or I watched it this morning on recording, then you just have to watch it. But anyway, I keep my dilutions sprays in these little Kleenex boxes. Sorry. Okay, yeah. Well, I do have it taped. It is lean. The camera is leaning forward, but I have it taped right here. Let me show you. Let me take a picture. I'll show you what this looks like. Y'all are gonna laugh. Hang on. Let me get my camera on. I'll just use an iPad because it's bigger. Hang on. Let me take a quick picture. Let's see. Where's my camera? oh. Sorry, Paul. I can't help it. All right, so let's see if I can get a picture of what I've got going on here. Not, well, that one might have been fuzzy. Hang on. All right, so. All right, let's see. Now my eyes are tearing up again because I'm laughing so hard. All right, so Paula's a hoot. I'm glad she's feeling better. Okay, so what I have here, and I know it's probably going to go yellow when I show it on the light, but anyway, so here's my camera on that tripod, but it has to lean forward, so I have it taped. I have the back leg taped to my heavy wood washi tape thingy holder. That's my washi tape wooden holder. It's real heavy, so I have it taped to that. But if that tape let goes, the whole thing's going to tump over, which it's done twice before. So this is what it looks like right here. Okay. yes, big old Paula. Okay, good one, Paula. Tissue. Okay, so these are my dilution sprays, and some of them are running a little low. I need to really replace some of them. I don't even know if I'll have enough to do this whole book. But I can add a little bit of water to them if they start. Like this one is almost empty. So I'll just take my, I need to, let me go spread, let me fill this up real quick, guys. So that I can add a little water to some of the ones that are almost empty. I'm going to be cracking up all day. All right, so like this one, and even some of the spray nozzles, you know, they get clogged if you don't use them like every day. So I'm just going to put a few squirts of water in here just to make it go a little further on some of the ones that just have a tiny bit left in them. And that's a great way to keep, use your acrylic paints as well when they get low, just to add water to them. I have, you know, if y'all remember, like when I did the crumpled papers and the art on the driveway and the art in the garage, those are the paints that I used in those shows, is just when there's just a little bit of leftover paint, add water to them. They're great for washes of color and to use up those leftover acrylic paints, and in this case some washes. Yeah, Sherry, I saw that. Sherry Pink did she on her YouTube, she did add some water to her dilutions too. I don't usually do that till they're like down to nothing, because I like them really vibrant. Okay, here's the white. I'm not going to use the white. Let me just get that out. Well, let me just pull the colors out here. So I've got Postbox red. I got two of those, so let me just keep one out. There's the washi one. I just a purple, and this is Pure Sunshine, another Pure Sunshine. Let me go ahead and use this Pure Sunshine with some water added to it because it's almost done too. I used to be able to get these like in two sets of two at Hobby Lobby. They still have some, but they don't, they only have like three sets. They don't have all of the colors. So I'm going to have to probably start ordering online. Although, who was it? Was it Artsology DFP Deb? Somebody I saw ordered some from somewhere. Don't ask me where. And they, and I'm probably not going to use black. I got the London Blue. And I think I have another one that's open. Oh, it might be Denise. Oh, that's my, we're on a group chat. Denise put me and Hubster and my mom, all of us are in group chat. So now my mom is texting Denise. Anyway, so if you hear the beeping, a cut grass green. Did I already pull out? Is this a different purple? Yeah, it's a different purple. This is another Postbox red. Another, did I get Pure Sunshine? Yeah, Pure Sunshine. I'm almost out of the lime. Here's, I got one that has a wash in it. There's a wash of lime. I'm trying to get all the colors. Do I have another lemon yellow wash? Okay, yeah, there's a lemon yellow wash and a pink and a turquoise. Do I have two turquoise? That's two different colors. Okay, so there we go. Sorry, guys, just have to listen to it. Because I have to, I wanted to be here when Denise gives me updates on booze competition. All right, so let me check the chat. Hi, Lisa, and everybody else popping in. Yeah, I'm just going to do a, hey, AJ, I'm going to do a, and Bunny and everybody else here. Thanks, everybody. I'm going to do an impromptu. I'm going to try to smack and drag, and I got to, you know what? I really should put a little bit of tape on here because I don't want, if this is going to be jiggling, it's going to knock my camera over. So let me just get a couple pieces of packing tape just so that this mat is not going to move. Just a couple pieces on the ends. Because it's going to be, when I smack and drag, it's going to move. And when it moves, I'm going to knock the camera over. I just know it. So, all right. Okay, so I got all these colors. And I'm just going to kind of put them over here, like under the tripod, so I can kind of see them. And my spray bottle of water. We're a little crooked here. I don't know. Okay, so if y'all are just joining us, I'm going to take my Dilutions journal, the new one that I got at Christmas and haven't used. The other one, I'm still working in it. And I'm going to smack and drag every page in here as backgrounds. Let's move the coffee because, you know, like Paul, I'm sorry, Paul, I can't help it. Paula's fun. I don't want to say she's fun to pick on. She's got such a great sense of humor and does such funny things. That is just fun to like repeat her funnies. And, you know, I'm going to try not to spray my coffee. So let me move that out of the way. Okay. So anyway, we're going to start with just the first page. And I haven't even really even cracked the spines on these yet. So I don't want to really spray this, the cardboard. So I'm just going to start with right here. All right. So it might get a little, I don't know. Let me turn this side lamp on. With white, it does get a little, you know, flashed out there. All right. I think that's good. So just bear with the camera, focus. There we go. Maybe if I keep that right over here, we can have a little bit of, I don't know if that helps much. Okay, so did Paula leave already? She ran. No, she didn't. I'm just teasing. Okay, so I'm going to, it's going to go back and forth from light to dark. It's going to flash out in between as I maneuver this because I have my overhead lamp off because there's going to be a big glare spot Your volume is a bit loud and weird. Slight cracking. Okay. Okay, how's that? I turned down the mic a little. Hang on, I've got to answer this text. Yeah, let's see, Denise, they didn't come in first, second, or third, guys. So, but you know, they can't win every one. And this was like tons and tons and tons of people at this one. So I know they'll be disappointed, but I think they're at Disney World. They'll get over it quicker at Disney World or Disneyland or whatever one is in Florida. Okay. Is that better, Paula? She wants to. is the volume better now that I turned it down just a little? I can turn it down a little more. How's that? Bueller. Hey, Jean. Oh, all right. I know they are, aren't they? They are. Perfect. Thanks. Okay. All right. So what we're going to start with, and you know, I'm just going to go for it. I'm going to not use more than, oh, let me get some baby wipes ready because when it starts getting muddy, we got to clean it off. So I'm just going to start with a teal, a lime green, and maybe a pink. These are all good colors. Just, and maybe, well, I only want to really stick with three. And then I'm going to spray it with some water. All right. And you won't be able to see it much right at now. But then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my book. Y'all wait for it. Brand new book. Here we go. And we smack and we drag. Okay. Now that's not a whole lot right there. So let me just go ahead and smack and drag on the side a little more. Maybe a little more on this side. So I'm just going to have to do a little bit bigger space. I mean, I'm going to have to cover a little bit bigger area. So that's what smack and drag does. You smack and you drag and you're picking up the ink. Okay. Hey, Moomie. And that will start the background of the page. Now, these pages are pretty thick. They're not like, they're thick, about like cardstock. Okay. So let me do a couple different colors. Let's go with some yellow. And I'm going to have to spread it out a little bit more. Let's go with, and I might have to also, depending on how much we do, go with paint if I run out of ink. Okay, so we're going to go with pink, yellow, and orange on this one. Then, again, got to spray it. And I don't think that we're going to have a problem with pages sticking with this. Now, if I go into any acrylic paint, then that might stick. So we might have to dry. But, you know, I think we'll be okay with the ink sinks in. These are not gessoed pages. The ink sinks in immediately. So I don't really think it's going to, I don't think we'll have a problem with sticking because the ink just soaks right in. Okay. So here we go. Smack and drag. Okay. So you can see. All right. And I just stuck my elbow in that. Let me get some baby wipes. And hopefully we can get like a couple of out of each one. And now when I close this, all right, so this one's wet and this one's, let's just see what happens when we close this. And I'm, you know, we'll see. If it starts looking muddy, I might want to dry them in between. All right, so let's go upside down. So that's not bad. But I don't want this to turn to brown when I close the book. You know what I mean, Vern? All right, so here we go. Let's go to the next color. Let's add a shot of red in there. A little bit more water. And let's go for it. Smack and drag. Okay, a little bit more on this side if I want. Smack and drag over there so you can see. And if I even wait like 10 seconds, I can just see it drying literally right before my eyes. It would be fun. And then put Saran wrap between the pages. It probably, Paula, if we if they were gessoed, but I mean it's soaking into these pages so quick. I don't think it would make much of a difference. I mean it's already dry. So I mean it's already soaked in that quick. But yeah, that would be cool. You need to do that on your next show, Paula. Get out the Saran wrap. I want to see that one in action. Now, I have done that before in watercolor. You know how you can put salt, like Barb, I think her last show or the show before, she put some salt on one of her watercolors. I think it was a week before. Those little characters that she did. So cute. But let's see, I want green. You can do that on watercolor paper and put something on top of it. It'll make like a, that same kind of look with not the same look as the salt, but I mean it'll repel the paint. But I don't think it's gonna work on this because it's soaking in so quick. All right, so let's see what happens here. Smack and drag. And a little bit of smack and drag. Now, right here where it's really bubbling, I mean, where it's really pooling, I'm going to go ahead and just take that off right there, where it's really pooling. Like that. So, isn't that cool? You see fish. And then I got the book. Well, sometimes it's upside down, sometimes it's right side up. All right, so let's see here. I think this is getting a little muddy. Turn the purples turning to brown, so I'm going to get rid of that. Let's put some pink, some purple, and some sunshine yellow. I'm just putting three random colors, guys. I don't want to get more than that because it'll get muddy. All right, next page. Okay, that's still going to pool there. All right, here we go. Smack and drag. Uh-oh, see, I bumped into the camera. Hang on. Wait for it. There we go. Let's get that little top area up there. Drag. See. All right. I'm pretty much picking up most of the paint, but I don't want that color. I don't want brown. I'm trying to keep it kind of vibrant. Because otherwise, I'll end up going into like more black backgrounds, and I want this to be really vibrant. Sorry, guys, I'm trying to think of colors while I'm talking. There we go. All right. Yeah, see, that's already soaked in. It's already dry. And I don't care if they wrinkle a little because y'all know that by the time I add collage paint and matte medium and all that on it, it takes all the wrinkles out. All right, so here we go. Smack and drag or twist or whatever. Okay, let's get a little more blue on that side. There we go. Maybe a little bit more up there. Just turn it over and drag it a little bit in the corner. And dilutions is messy. Let's add a little purple in there. It's very staining on your hands. Know what I mean, Vern? Sorry, I can't help. We'll see what happens. We'll do a peruse through the book when we're done. So if y'all are watching the recording, whoops. This is going to take a while. But I just told the girl, I'll come on smack and drag some pages. All right, a little bit. Let's go a little green. A little water. No, I don't know. Why would we? Well, I'm not going to say why would I need it when I have this, but. I'm trying not to bump the camera, guys, but obviously I keep doing it. A little bit more on this side. Let's get the rest of that. Oh, yay. I'm gonna have to. My camera is like as tall as the book, so I keep bumping into it. I don't know. Maybe I need to move the camera up more. We'll see. I just don't want to knock the whole thing over. All right. All right, fresh colors. Let's go with some turquoise. some After Midnight, and some Red Vibrant Page. Hey, Jess. Water. And this is like a craft. It's the equivalent of using a craft mat. It's not. It's non-porous, so nothing's sinking in. You're gonna have to use something that is waterproof. All right. Next page. There we go. Try not to hit the camera. Smack and drag. Ooh, that's pretty. The other way, a little smack and drag. There we go. Okay, that one's pooling just a little, and I got my elbow in that one. I've got a whole thing of baby wipes, like right here. Dee's camera fell over, and we thought I fell out of my chair. Yeah. I haven't fallen out of my chair yet, although I've tripped over it. I've fallen down. I've tripped over the camera. I've tripped over the tripod and fall. I've tripped over the rug and spilt my coffee at least 3 times. Once onto my old phone. I mean, it didn't hurt. I mean, I caught it in time, but I was kind of worried. All right, so let's see. All right, so see, that's pretty much, except for right at these drip edges, that's already all soaked in. All right. We'll do a journal slip at the end. I'm just enjoying doing it and chatting with everybody. So this show is not probably going to be for everybody. It's the ink blot test show. Speaking of books, I saw that book, an ink blot test book. I said, that would be fun to do on stream. Do an ink blot, but I didn't get it. But I did think of you, Jeannie, when I saw it. Not because it was an ink blot, but because just a book on screen. But I did get 2 new books yesterday. So I'll show you those in just a second. All right, so there's got a kind of a blob right there. So let me just kind of pick up that one blob. And we're going to go to the next page. Here we go. Smack and drag. Smack and drag. And I don't care if it's getting on this or here or anywhere. It's going to get covered all over the whole book. So that doesn't bother me. The cover is going to get covered, painted and everything anyway. So we'll go with that. All right. I might get one more something out of it before it turns kind of muddy. All right. Let's go to the next page. But yeah, I did get a couple books. For those of y'all that weren't tweeting with me yesterday, I was trying to find Danny Gregory's new book, Art Before Breakfast. And unfortunately, wait, maybe my camera needs to come up just a little here. Unfortunately, nobody has it. Everybody's saying it's out of print. Barnes & Noble, Books a Million, even Amazon doesn't have it in stock. So either, I don't know what happened. Maybe, sorry guys, let me adjust my camera again. Now I'm all discombobulated. Looks all crooked. They don't have it anywhere. Let's see here. Just a minute, guys. There we go. They don't have it anywhere. Can't even order it. It's like out of stock everywhere. So, what did Jeannie say? Jeannie thought of me when she's talking about. I thought of you when thinking about books for the show. All right, so that one, there's that one. And see, a little bit getting on the edges, which is fine. I just gotta quit knocking into the camera. Okay, let's go with some 2 shades of purple. There's a dark blue purple and then the purple. And then let's go with where's just the blue. So let's do the purples and blues on this one, and that's all. I'm trying to mix it up, you know, have different combinations every time. All right. So let's smack and drag. Ooh, look at that one. Let me shut the book on that one and like make it, because that was a lot. There. All right, and just a little bit more on the top. There we go. So that one's cool. I can get probably another whole spray out of this one, add a little water. But what I'm trying to get at while I'm talking and doing this is that I did not get the Danny Gregory book because no one had it. But I had a leftover gift card at Barnes & Noble. So I thought, I got to buy something. Jeannie will be disappointed if I don't have it, something on my next show. And let me add one more color in here. Let's go with red for the next one more pull out of this. Speaking of pulls, I thought, you know, I want to do some vibrant jelly plating where they're really vibrant. And if I do it on deli paper, they never turn out as vibrant as on a white paper. But I love the deli paper, you know, the thinness of it and the texture of the deli paper, but the paint never seems very vibrant. So what I did is I did, and maybe we'll play with this if we have time. I painted a whole bunch, you can't tell, but I painted, now some of them have a little black left over off my scraping, but I painted a stack of deli paper with white paint. So that when I jelly plate with these, the white vibrancy of the paint will make the paint colors more vibrant. You know what I mean, Vern? It's available in the UK. Would you like me to get for you? What's available in the UK? Oh, no, Mumi. No, because the shipping is ridiculous. Now the shipping is, yeah, Jean just said, just sell the deli paper, Dee Dee. Yeah, well, it's basically the same thing, Jean, except I just use white acrylic paint. So, yeah. Have you done that, Jean? Did I miss that show? Jean's my jelly plate mentor. Anything I know about jelly plating, I've learned from Jean. So, she's obviously done that before because she's telling me to gesso them. Yeah, no, I don't want, no, Mumi, because the shipping would be crazy. It'll come out, I'll find it, or they'll reprint it. If I have to write Danny Gregory, I mean, I will. Okay, well, let's try one here. All right, so, and I tried not to completely cover. Now, because the jelly plate's only going to cover that much area, I didn't worry about getting all the way to the edges. And then I also left some areas, like, so it'll give it a little, you know, light, dark thing. But let's go ahead and do that right here. There we go. Let's drag it. So, it's kind of hard to tell. Does it seem? All right, let's do one without the white paint now. All right, so here we go. Yeah, see, it is obviously brighter with the white paint. You may not be able to see. It's just kind of like when you do a napkin journal thing. If you peel your napkins apart and put them on white paper, they're much more vibrant than if you don't put them on a white paper. So, like, you can see can y'all tell? Can y'all see the vibrancy difference? Yeah. So, what I'm saying is when I jelly plate with these white painted sheets, the paint will be much more vibrant than not. And I love using the thin deli papers, but I never like that they're not very bright. But if you gesso or white acrylic, in my case, I just used white acrylic, but like Jean said, gesso, then look at the difference in the vibrancy. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so let's just kind of throw those over there. Thank you, Mumi. That was very sweet of you. But I don't, that the shipping isn't going to be a killer. You know what I mean, Vern? Okay, so let me go ahead and get this cleaned off, and we'll go to the next. And I'll just keep getting clean ones. But, yeah, this is what's going to happen. Yeah, so if we'll see how long this takes me to do all these pages, and maybe we'll get the jelly plate out. Unless y'all see that Dar comes on, or, you know, y'all said Laurel had to work today, because this is usually the days they stream. And let's go with the little lime green, too. Did I already put lime green on there? I don't think I did. Don't want to get it too much. The more colors you add, the more chance you're going to get mud. And it's available on Amazon. Okay, because we looked yesterday and they did. It was out of stock. I'll double check again later. I'll get it myself. It's on Amazon. Okay, so here we go. Smack and drag. And I know Paula either. I haven't seen Paula show it on her show, but she said her mom got it for her. So I don't know if Paula's actually got it in her hot little hands yet. But I know she's got it up there. So I know it's out there is what I'm saying. And I've seen it all over Twitter. People have tweeted pictures of it. Now, was that just like promos? It could be, you know, it could just have been promos. People out there just, you know, to promote the book and had copies of it before it came out. But I don't know. All right. So let me go to the next page here. And I'm going to have to need some red and some other colors in here. Some oranges. Because I want them all to be kind of different, you know. So I'm just smacking and dragging. And then let's see, let's add some yellow in here. You put it on Instagram, Paula? I knew your mom got it for you, but I didn't see you stream it yet. So, yeah. So what I'm saying is I know it's out there, guys. You know? All right, let's add some orange and some pink. And let's go with a dark, let's go with the midnight here. Hey, Bard. We're smacking and dragging. Okay, that one's got a little bit of a puddle. Let me get the puddle off. Maybe one. Okay, next page. I think if I just add some water here, there's enough for a couple more pulls off of this. I know the camera keeps bumping and I keep shifting things. So after we get them all done, I'll do a flip through, you know. All right, let's clean that off. Next page. Make sure that nothing's sticking. Nope, they're not sticking at all. All right, let's go with the turquoise and lime. So these are the only colors that I have, and the dilutions is like 3, 6, 10, 12 colors or so. You know, if I get out my... if I get out some washed out acrylic paints, we can even get more colors. But I'm really liking using the inks because they're not sticking the pages together like paint's going to. All right, smack, smack and drag. A little bit more on this side, a little smackaroo on that side. Okay, whoops. I think there's probably enough paint with maybe one more color. Let's add a little red spray. Yeah, I mean, full speed ahead. Yep, Carrie, full speed ahead. So these are all going to be, you know, backgrounds for other mixed media collage projects. Instead of, it's going to force me to do more color instead of a lot of the, you know, darker, but that's just my, what I like. I like darker, mysterious looking pieces, but you know, we'll get out of our comfort zone. Although, I mean, I do like bright things too. Like look at our, Peaceful Sloth. That was about as colorful as you could get, right? And add a little bit more water. And a twist. Add a twist on that one. Going page to page. Still trying. Yeah, I know. I do have a black sweater thing on, but I do have a cream color shirt on underneath. Probably not the smartest thing in the world. Because I really started out with just drawing today. And here's what I'm working on. Y'all missed it at the beginning. I'm working on a drawing of Sean Connery. I told y'all, y'all heard the story a gazillion times about Hubster finding that ad. I'm showing it to Samantha. Oh my gosh. Okay, here we go. Smack and twist. And let's just close that one and just let some of that green come over on this side. And another one spray of water. Smack and twist. A little on this side, a little smack and drag action. Next page. Like I said, I think there's 100 pages front and back. Maybe, I'm not sure. 100 pages front and back? Yeah. Yeah. Two shades of dollar. Let's add some greens. And a little bit more turquoise. It only takes one squirt of each and a couple squirts of water to do, you know, two pages here. Well, actually four pages by the time, you know. I just want different colors. They're all starting to have a lot of turquoise in them. So let me kind of put the turquoise aside, replace it with blue. Let's go with purple instead of like orange. Let's move that over here. I've got kind of trying to go back and forth between the two. And I also have some of the SEI tumble dye sprays and all that. But here's the thing. Again, the reason I'm wanting to use these in particular is because I know they're not going to stick to pages. And because I'm not drying them, I'm just like repeating one after the other. Yeah, the book is a little on the heavy side, Pa. It's not like our Big Mama Jamba very big sketchbook. It's not quite that big, but it's pretty big. I mean, it's pretty heavy because of the cover. And a little bit of purple water. Let's add a little bit of blue to that. Probably get one more. I'll call it a pull for lack of a better word. Hubster's back. Hear the garage door open. All right, let's go ahead and add some red. Maybe a I'm trying to stay away from the pink and turquoise for a couple minutes. Let's try. I'm determined. See, and this is what I would do if y'all weren't here. I would totally complete this book because I couldn't, knowing that I want this project to look like this. Let me close this, get soak up some of that red. I would totally be doing this. This is how I would be working if y'all weren't here. I would totally just not stop. I don't stop till my project's done. I mean, if I totally can help it. I mean, things happen, of course, but. All right, it's time to clean this one off. Paint. Yeah, then I'll collage and mixed media them, Pam. Yeah. They'll be like backgrounds, just like my other collage journal is, but instead of dark you know, darker colors. Hey, honey, I'm streaming. I'm trying to force myself to use lighter colors. So, and I don't want to use pink. So let's go with yellow, purple. I'm looking at what I haven't used for a minute. And blue. I think I just used blue, but we'll go. I'm streaming. Sorry, guys. Kind of yelled in your ear there. All right. All right, now let's go with some pink and... did we use purple? Yeah, we use purple there. Haven't used green. Oh, let's go with a dark green. You are not drawn, Sean, anymore. Yeah. For those of y'all that weren't here when I first started, I was saying that Hubster said, I'll commission you to do some portraits for me. He loves old movies, right? Like, you know, with John Wayne, Robert Mitchum, and who else did I have? Lawrence of Arabia. I think 8 of them sketched out for him, ready to go. And, but when I was looking for reference pictures, I saw that picture of Sean, and oh my gosh, that was the best picture ever of Sean Connery. And so, hang on, don't go anywhere. So when, he said, well, which one are you drawing? Are you drawing Robert Mitchum? You drawing Lawrence? Which one are you drawing this morning? And I went, nothing. No, I'm just working on he goes, you're working on Sean, aren't you? So yeah, I'm working on Sean. All right, let's go with, let me see what colors I've used. Pink. What color haven't I used for a bit? Oh, I kind of used a lot of them. I need some more red. I always love the red. Let's go with red. I haven't used turquoise for a couple of turquoise. Yellow. I could add a squirt of black on a couple of them. We'll just see what happens. We'll do that next. Oh, let's go ahead and do it now. Let me find the black. Now, this will make mud real quick, so I can't. I'm going to just try to keep it on the periphery, because that's going to make mud real quick if I use a lot of black. But let's just see what happens. Oh, I said I wasn't going to do that, didn't I? I'll try to keep them all vibrant, but that's kind of cool. We'll go with a little black in there. All right, next page. Let's add a little water, because it does make it black will make things stand out and make things dramatic, you know. But look, see, it's already getting muddy. Well, you can't see me. It's already starting to get muddy. Hey, okay, Carol. We're getting there, guys. I think we're over halfway. We're getting there. Look, a little tiny bit of black, turquoise, and red. Yummy. All right, here we go. We're doing smack and dragon. Smack and dragon. I got to write that down. There's an idea in that. Hang on. So, excuse the squeaky chair, guys, because I am going from left to right. So every time I do this, it goes squeak, 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 squeak. Okay. Hang on. Smack and dragon. That goes in the idea journal, in the idea notebook. There's an idea in that. Okay. Next page. Oh, let me add a little bit of water to use this up. Are you doing the journaling by phone? I did it, cheeky girl. But what I did is I made art cards out of them, and I've sent them to Shannon already. She's probably got them. I'm sure she's got them. But I saw that she had a cold or wasn't feeling good or something. So she hasn't even made a video or emailed or anything. So I'm thinking she's probably got them. Not that she has to show them on a video, but I haven't heard that she got the mail. But I sent them all to Shannon, except for the few of y'all that I did a drawing for. And I included some of them in your Happy Mail. But yeah, I did the journaling by fives in a sort of our own sort of way. All right, so let's go back with let's do black and white. It'll mix and make some pretty grays, I think. Let's give it a, and the white is the only one that you really have to shake up. It has a little ball in it. All right, so we're gonna go with black and white. And maybe, let's see, one color. Let's go with yellow. Let's see what we get. Black, white, and one color. I'm getting bored with the same ones. All right, here we go. And pick up a little more there. The rest of that. It's cool. The yellow isn't as vibrant as I would like it, and this will have to be cleaned in between each one because we'll just have a big puddle of gray. All right, so let's do that again. Let's do some black, white, and red this time, which will get pink. We'll get pink when the red hits the white. Add some water. All right, here we go. That's kind of cool. Needs a little more up here. Let's use the rest of that up. Oh, if you're asking me if I'm doing the journaling by fives right now, no. I'm sorry. I might have misunderstood the question. I'm not doing that now. I'm just trying to fill up this journal with backgrounds. And we're getting there. We probably have at least, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We probably have about 25 more. So if y'all want to get some coffee and come back. Okay, let's go with some red. A purple and a white. Let's see what happens. So that'll give us more pastels, you know? All right, let's see what we get with this. Works out, Tammy. Well, I just don't mess around, Jean. I just like, hey, let's just go for it. Let's just go for it. Okay, let's add one more color. Let's add some blue and white, and then we'll probably get a nice sky blue in there. A lot of water. See what happens. I just must have missed the blue. There we go. See how you can see like a pastel-y, the white is kind of toning down, because you know we want something different here too. All right, let's add another squirt of blue and some more white water. I'm still, yeah. Oh, I know, Jean. You couldn't take this. I know. You've come a long way though, Jean. You sure have. Got to say, Jean has come a long way. All right, let's add a squirt of black in there now. with the leftover. Drag and twist. Let's turn it over the other side without hitting the camera. I'm liking that. We're gonna keep adding some black and white for a while. Let's go with purple. I probably should have cleaned it off first. Purple, black, white. Water. I'm getting there, guys. Look. We're getting there. Maybe about 20 more. I'm gonna have to do a giveaway to make it up to you guys. Oh my gosh, Dee, we're bored stiff. Okay, that does have to be cleaned off now. And I'll readjust the camera when I remove the board here when I'm done. All right, next, let's see. Let's go with, we haven't done turquoise, white, and black. Turquoise, black, white. Maybe a little bit more turquoise. She won't touch down on your butt color. I don't think that this will happen to her, Linda. See, that I like. That's probably my favorite one so far. Love that. Let's add a little bit more of the same colors because I'm liking it. Jeannie, as soon as I finish this, I'll show the books. I'm almost done. I'll wash my hands and show the new books. All right, I think I can keep it with a little bit of gray. Let's go with, I'm loving those, that colors. I'm loving the turquoise, black, and white. So we're going to go with a couple more of those. Getting a little, the whole book's getting a little fluffy because of the wet, you know. All right, now we're going to take and we're going to add a touch of pink right in the middle. I mean, look how much we've done, and the sprays have really hardly gone down at all. All right, we're going to do the dark purple, white. Oh, and that's the first time that I've... I hope I didn't spray the camera. That's the first time I've sprayed it the wrong way. Like up in the air. I think I missed the camera, but I'm getting off center there. This is kind of getting to be a hot mess, isn't it, guys? I'm really liking these, though. A little bit more white on that side. There we go. Come back, camera. Don't fall over. Don't fall over. Dee Dee just sprayed her nose. Now, luckily, I've been really trying to really, you know, notice which way the sprays are going. All right, let's add with that purple. Let's go with some red in there. That'll be pretty. Some more white. Some water. All right, here we go. It's getting a little, unwieldy there. Ooh, mama, I like that one. Only, let's see, we only got like maybe six more to go. One, two, three, maybe 10. There's more in there than it looks. Okay, we're getting there. All right, let's see, let's go with green. Lime, white, and yellow maybe. Oh, green. Jean's gonna like this one. And maybe just a little bit of shot of yellow. Hi Pam, hi Cindy. Anybody else popping in? We're filling a whole Dilutions journal with smack and drag. Ooh, look, that's pretty. Need some more dark on this side, though. There we go. Okay, now let's add a little bit more green and a shot of black. And more water. Twist. That's a cool one, too. Some white to that. Some more water. We're getting there, guys. Almost done. Seriously, we're almost done. All right, let's go with some turquoise. Lime, yellow, and white. Water. It's getting hard to fold those last couple pages. Oh, sorry again. Get a little more turquoise on that side. Now let's add a shot of with the turquoise and the green and the white. I'm just looking at the page before. What would I like with it? Let's add a shot of orange. Not pure sunshine, I want orange. I haven't used much orange, have I? Well, that's because it usually goes brown. Okay, so let's see. Here we go. Smack and drag. Smack and drag. I know I'm a little off camera, guys. If I try to get any closer, I'm going to be smacking into the camera. All right, let's go with one more red. I only think I got two more pages left. Red. Uh-oh. Come back here. I dropped it on the floor. White. And let's go with some purple. Water. All right, let's see if I can get those first, the first and last page here with something on it. Let me just drag up the rest of that, that very last page. Okay. All right. I'm worn out. How long did that take? An hour? Okay, y'all can come back now. Y'all can come back now. All right, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove this. Oh, yeah, I taped it down. I forgot. So that it wouldn't move. Let me slide it out from under the tripod. Throw that out of the way. Here's our two. There's the difference between, even out of the light, look. There's the there's the one painted and not painted. When I inked the deli paper. White background, no white background. See the vibrancy difference? Because I wanted to jelly plate some deli paper. But I don't like the way that the deli paper is not as vibrant as you would do it on a white sheet of paper. So I said, well, I love the deli paper. I like the white of vibrancy. So why not just paint the deli paper white before you jelly plate on it? So you can really see. Now, I haven't tried dilutions on the jelly plate. I don't know. I'd be kind of afraid to, Eileen. All right, let's see if I can fix my camera again, guys. Let me get my focus thing here. Make sure that the tape isn't going anywhere. Okay, there we go. All right, I'm going to wash my hands, and then I'll show the books to Jeannie, and then we'll look at this, see what happened in an hour. Let's see what kind of damage we did in 1 hour. What did we do in 1 hour? Okay. All right. Give me 1 second, guys, to go wash my hands. Let me pick these up. All right. I'll BRB. And I know it stains, and I got the bulk of it off, but fingernail polish remover, if it doesn't bother your skin too much, is the way to get that kind of stuff off. All right. I need coffee. Where's my coffee? Which is, I'm sure, cold. Okay, so we'll look at this in just a second. Let me show you what I got at the bookstore, though. Like I said, I was looking for the Danny Gregory Art Before Breakfast book, which is nowhere to be found. They all say it's out of print, out of stock, can't order it, can't get it, whatever. I'll find it eventually. But in the meantime, I got these two books. Now, I know Colleen has this one, The 20 Ways to Draw a Tree. Hey. Are you sure?
Yeah. You just have grilled cheese. I want okay. A couple dogs.
All right, that's fine. Okay. Do what? Yeah. So 20 ways to draw a tree. There's 20 ways to draw all kinds of things. Let me see. Let me turn on my overhead light now. Now that I don't have that glare spot. There we go. I turned off my overhead light when we had that thing there because it gave us a glare. Colleen has all of these, I think. There's 20 ways to draw flowers, 20 ways to draw trees, 20 ways to draw bugs and birds and all kinds of things. Peeking or spray. Peeking spray drawer and after getting rid of cobwebs, color wash the packaging. And I like anything with graphic designs to them. And so I really liked, and by the way, it's not just trees. There's what it is there's 20, you draw, it's 20 trees on one page. Trees, mushrooms, birds, stemmed flowers, ferns, pine cones, leaves, acorns, snowflakes, berries, herbs, snails, feathers, winter trees, daisies, owls, beetles, flowers, clouds, apples, grasses, tree seeds, eggs, shells, logs, stars, nest, roses, fossils, blooms, stones, twigs, dragonflies, tulips, grains, bees, seed heads, moths, peacock feathers, caterpillars, dandelions, thistles, butterflies, root vegetables, and citrus fruits. There's 20 of each of those. So I will do a little flip through here for you so you can kind of see. They're like very graphic looking, and I just love the designs of them. And what I thought would be fun was to take one of something you like and draw it over and over and over on a big one big sheet of paper, and might make your own kind of paper, with just one of the designs, like one of the feathers or one of the leaves. Just pick one you like and do a whole page of just that one. That would be good to do in here too, some of that on the mixed media. But there's snails and the feathers. So there's 20 of each at least. I don't know. There may be, I don't know, maybe exactly 20. Let's see, 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, there's 20, like 20 owls, beetles, flowers, clouds, apples, grasses, seed, tree seeds, eggs. So you can see if you like any kind of graphic design, how you would love this. I know, Terry, right? And she has, if you go on Amazon, you can look at all the different kinds. Look for, well, I don't know if it's all her, Eloise Renouf. I don't know if they're all by her, but there you go. This one's by her. I don't know if there's different designers or if they're all by her. I'm not sure. But if you look for 20 ways to draw, just put in 20 ways to draw on Amazon and you'll get all the different kinds. Dragonflies, tulips, grains, bees, moths, peacock feathers, caterpillars, dandelions, look. Did y'all not see the author? Eloise, Renouf. Okay, thistles, oops. Thistles. But I think it would be fun. I mean, you could even carve your, carve a stamp if you want to. Butterflies, root vegetables, citrus fruits. And I know there's all different ones. There's 20 ways, and just another one that was referenced on the back, 20 ways to draw a cat. And then they probably have all kinds of animals with that, not just cats. But to take one of them and to do, let me just pick something out, one example. Do I like a tree? That one's a, because I want to do something easy for the example. But you could take, I want more of a solid color. Let's see, what could I do it on? I don't really want a mixed media paper. Let's see. Oh, I know, a craft paper. That'd be perfect. Right, let's see. Or black, and let's do one on black and one on craft. Then I'll show the, I gotta show another book. Hang on, Jeannie. And I gotta show the one we just worked on. But let's go with the craft and a black Sharpie marker. Let's make sure this one is working. Okay. And if you did a whole page, even if you did one, if you did a, I kind of got off track on that one. But then turn it over and did them. And I'm doing these very fast. So I drew it the same way. Good grief. I went upside down and drew it the same way. Anyway, do them a little neater than this, of course. You could even like cut you out a little pattern for the outside shape. But, and then so that they're kind of like a connecting pattern. And then let's see here. I guess I could have just started with one row, you know, one long line like that. Now I do one upside down. We'll go with one upside down. And then those look kind of odd. But you could do this. I won't fill the whole sheet. And I'm not even really copying it exactly. I'm just kind of getting the idea, okay? But you could do it more precise if you really wanted a whole pattern sheet. Okay, let's do one upside down. But here's the thing. If you did it on craft paper, look. Then you go in with a white pencil. And you can do play with that. Let's like kind of put a little bit on the inside here. You could color like one section or two sections like that. Let's do some outlining. See? Like that. And then you could even outline them. I'm doing this very quickly just to give you the idea. See? How cool is that? Bye, Sherry. I know, right? Or go with a piece of black paper and draw them all in white. And I'm just going to try to, well, let's just go with a straight line and then kind of do it this way. Let's do this so we can get three on there. And you could like make your own pattern paper with just one design. And then you could even go in here with metallic. Let's see if I can find something gold or something here in a second. Okay, then let's get a green gold. Oh, I got one that's not opened yet. I should have just picked up the other one, but that's okay. We'll go with it. Well. Let's see here if it shows up. I might have to go over it with white. Might have got too much water in there too. That's okay. Then you'd have, you know, take more time. Do like every other one or different ones on each one. Got too much water in my brush. I just want to the idea on there. What do y'all think? Isn't that kind of cool? Yes, Prismacolor pencils. So you can see right? And then, so that's the kind of stuff that I like to see and imagine when I see a design. You know, and I just thought, I just looked at that one right there. And you can always cut these out or whatever, you know. I mean, whatever you can do with any kind of design. All right, so there's that one. The other book I got was, wait for it. Glorious Gardens, Creative Coloring for Grown-Ups. And they had 5 different ones of these. They had birds, they had the gardens, they had paisley, they had, I don't remember all of them. This was my favorite one. And it was only bargain price, $6.98. I left it on there to show y'all. So it is, and I know y'all probably have some of these, seen some of them. I've got other ones as well. But I just think that the designs in them, see if it'll flip for me. I'll just turn the pages. Can y'all, let's see, maybe if I go right about there. That's not working either. Let's see. Bird cages and houses and bugs and leaves. But there's just so much you can do with these kind of books like this. I mean, you can cut out individual, you know, you could copy this and cut one of these out, cut these out individually. Yes, I do like bees. But, you know, like that steampunk one I have, that's not as big as this, but it has all steampunk people in it to color. Same kind of thing. There's tons of, look, there's more of those little. But you can just, you know, use a design or just if you want to just color. You just want to sit down and color if you want. Get some markers out. If I colored in this, I would use my cheap Crayola bullet tip markers. The water, they're not water soluble. They're water, they're non-alcohol based or just the cheap water based. They don't move with water. They're just water based. And that's the kind of stuff that you could color something in with that and then shade it with color pencil. That's a good way to practice your shading, is to color something with a marker. I'll have to do, let's see, that's a good one to show on. Hang on, let me, let me make a copy of this. Hang on, let me plug in my little printer here. Put that boot up for a second, and then I'll show you what I mean by how to use this. Let me show you the rest of them here. Some pretty roses. Some, I think those are poppies. That would be a good one too. I actually like that one a little better. We'll do that one. Just so you can see all the kind of designs. So even if you didn't actually sit and color, look at that one. That's another good one to do. We'll do that one. I keep changing my mind. Just so you can see all the different ones. Okay, hang on. Let me make a quick copy of this. Just on some copy paper, just to show y'all. This isn't my photo printer. This is just a little, Denise just got this for me to have right by my desk. It's just a little black and white and color. Well, it's color, but it's just a small little Canon, I think, printer. It's not my big Epson photo printer that I have downstairs. So this one takes a little slower on the output. You know what I mean? You know what I mean, Vern? I mean, it's just good for a handy little copier or scanner right next to my desk. Okay, I'll just do the one. Wait, CB! Oh, okay, bye. I know people can't stay. I wanted to go show the book we just did, but I'm recording. Okay, so now, let me just put something under it, so because that's kind of crunchy. Go like that. All right, let me get my camera. Let me zoom in a little. And then that way when we show the book, it'll be zoomed in too. Okay, where's my thing? Autofocus. It's like a little formula here. Okay. All right. Okay. So now let me get my little markers I was talking about. I have a couple sets of them. I really like these. Are my favorite play markers. I don't have Copics or alcohol-based markers. I don't use the kind of markers where you do the blending and all that. Because if I'm doing blending and stuff, I do it with color pencil or paint. That's just me, you know. I mean, if you want to see someone that can do some amazing color blending with like Copics, it's like Jess, you know. But I just like these little cheap Crayola, and they're bullet tip. Let me get the green ones here. Bullet tip like this. The reason I like the bullet tip is because you can get thick. Well, that's not showing up on there. Let me get a darker color to show up. And something other than deli paper. Never have paper right when you need it. You know what I mean, Vern? Here we go. You can get thick lines, thin lines. You know, it can color a white. Now, it's not streaky. It is streaky, and they don't blend like Copics or anything like that. Okay, just saying. They're just cheap Crayola bullet tip markers. But what's cool about them is because they're water-based, let's just do one leaf here. Let's just do this one leaf. So I'm just going to color this whole leaf in a light green. And this is just a good way to practice your shading for any technique, any time you need to know how to shade something. This is just a good practice. For practice your shading. So I'm just going to color in this whole leaf. And as long as it's wet, as long as the edges are wet, it'll blend. But it's not going to blend like a Copic where you can go back in there and go over it and make it blend out. It's just not, you know, these are just water-based markers. And so they're not going to be as blendy like Copics. But I don't do art with markers, except like, you know, playing with it, something like this. So I don't really, I just don't use them. Cam is really proficient at alcohol-based markers. You know, the Spectrum Noir and the Copics and the Pris, all those kinds, you know, all the different brands. He can whip out a face and in markers in a heartbeat. But he started with the manga, you know. Okay, so here we have just a color. And a lot of that dark right there is from the lines in the leaves. See where the lines in the leaves are? Okay, the lines in the leaves made that darker already. So you get a natural bit of shading or blending. But then if you take your color pencils and and then let's make sure that's dry. Hang on, I'm gonna hit it with the heat gun, guys, because color pencils, Prismacolor, any kind of wax-based pencils, you don't wanna go over something wet because it just won't work. You're more likely to just tear your paper than anything. So let me dry this. Especially on this thin copy paper, you know? And then, you can go in and start playing with shading. And what I mean is like getting your darks like in the dark area and then lightly feathering out. You know, that's what I mean by practicing your blending so that you can't see any harsh lines. So I'm just going in there where I know I want the darkest darks. That. And it's just a good way to practice if you just want to sit and, you know, you want to do something creative but you don't really want to do a full something, then you can just, you know, get out your coloring books, your cheap Crayola markers and some color pencils and practice your blending. All right, so now I can start feathering it out even more, maybe right along the veins. And people that are proficient in Copics do all this with markers. They do all this blending and line work and all that. Okay. I just like using color pencils. It's just my preference. I just like them. I just really like them. Now let me get a darker green. I should probably sharpen these. I actually need it even darker than that. I want my darkest dark green. Now I do will have to sharpen this one because it's not sharpened at all. And then, hang on, it broke again. 1 second. And then go in there like halfway through where we just did and darken it even more. And you can just get some really nice effects with cheap equipment. If that's all you can get, then, you know, it doesn't have to be Prismacolor pencils. This will work with any kind of color pencil. There's a little bit of dark right along the curl. And then you can even go in there with some, put those back in here real quick, some black and white. So the very, very darkest, right in the crease there and right along the edge. And you just kind of make sure you're feathering it out. This is where the practice comes in. So you don't see any kind of lines. It's all blended. And this is also good when you just want to sketch down ideas. You know, you want to sketch down a quick tree or a quick something leaf, whatever. This is just a good way to get a lot of detail really fast once you know, have done a few. And it just helps you practice your color pencil blending. See? Maybe there's a little shadow, like right along those holes there. Real dark shadow. Maybe right along there. Okay. And then depending on what kind of paper you're working on, you can get a few white highlights, or, you know, like I could have used a light yellow or whatever, just to give it a... And if the paper doesn't seem conducive to taking the white pencil, then go in there with... Just a dab of white paint to hit it with a couple of little highlights here and there. And this just helps you practice your blending and your... Okay. Anyway. There's that. So those are the two new books I got. So now... Yeah, I know. Me too, Carrie. I love color pencils. Just my favorite. And that's, you know, what I do most of my portraits. If y'all are coming in late, right now I'm working on a Sean Connery. And I've just got in the darkest darks and the whitest whites, other than maybe a, you know, a touch of white acrylic paint somewhere. And now I've got to go in and do his tan. He's got a dark tan in his photograph. So I'm going to go in there and do all the flesh colors next. So that's what I was working on before I came here. Okay, so now let's go ahead and look real quick at what we did in the book. All right, let me fix my chair and my little blanket on the chair so I don't sit on the cold seat. But I'm constantly fixing it. I will get a new chair eventually. I swear I will. All right. So here's what we did, other than the very first page, this right here. We didn't do this, but let's go ahead and look through what we did. These are, I don't need, well, I'll count them in my head. So. And I'll crease them as I go. Turn this into one of those ASMRs. Shh, you know. The sound videos. They're still damp. I'll probably hit them with the heat gun or leave the book, you know, kind of standing up to dry. And this is all dilutions ink. So it will reactivate. If I hit come in here with some white paint or gesso, it will reactivate. I think I'm about page 23, I think. I lost count. Two or one. Yes, Eileen. I think I'm about up to page 50. I think there's about 65 turns. So if you double that, you know, I only counted just the every flip, not every page. So I think that was like 65 double pages there. And you can see it got a little warped already compared. I mean, you know, the spine is twisted just a little. So if ideally what I'll do is I'll mash this down and I'll put a heavy book on it to try to kind of reform the spine while it's wet, while it's damp, you know? Like I said, front, back, front, back, front, back is the way to go if you do not want to warp the spine. I kind of bent it back, so we'll see. If I put something heavy on it, it'll probably be okay. You know? Not that it's gonna stay that way anyway once I get crack-a-lacking in it, you know what I mean, Vern? Yes, Eileen. So there we go. So I'll put something heavy on it while it is damp. All right, so I wanted to do, and I only think I did about, I'll see how many I did, and I've already put ink on a couple. But what I was talking about earlier, let me look around here and see what I can put on here that's heavy. I mean, really heavy. Here we go. My tub of paper. Okay, so I stuck it under my tub of paper. All right, so what this was about, let me move all these sample things out of the way. What this was about is I love deli paper jelly pulls. Jelly plate pulls with deli paper, but I don't like how it's not vibrant. The colors are just not as vibrant as if you used white paper. So I said, let's go ahead and paint self. Let's paint some of the deli papers with white paint. You could gesso, white acrylic paint or gesso, and then jelly plate with the white base coated dried deli papers. So here's the difference between no white paint and white paint with the dilutions ink. So what I thought I would do is, and this one just got a little bit of black was on the palette. When I picked up the white paint, I picked up some black. So there's a little bit of black on that one, but doesn't matter. We'll put some paint on it too. But all these have white. You can see they all have a coat of white in varying degrees of coverage. And I did not worry about going all the way to the edge. You know, I mean, the reason I would want to do these is then to take these pages that have been jelly printed and use those for collage, mixed media, you know, whatever. But I just wanted them more vibrant. So you can see just how different coverages I use. And I just scraped it on with a card with white acrylic paint and a, you know, craft, you know, we call it a credit card, craft card, key card, whatever, you know, plastic card, and scraped it on in varying degrees of coverage. And then that way, I guess I did a lot. I did kind of Hubster walk by my room, goes, what's all those papers all over your floor? Because I basically did as many as my floor could take, laid out, because you stack them, you know, they're going to stick. So I had to lay them all out. So here you can see the difference in vibrancy with the ink when you paint one white and you don't paint one white. So we're going to get out the jelly plate and we're going to jelly plate those ones that I've already base coat it. Now, I'm just going to get some stencils and some the jelly plate. I'm not going to get fancy. I'm not going to get out the hair dryer and do all my jean techniques that I have written down. Okay, so don't expect anything fancy. If you want to see fancy jelly plating, go check out Jean and Patty Tolly Parrish, and Carrie does some amazing things on black. Paula's been doing jelly plating. This is going to just be strictly some paint, some stencils, and some pulls. Just saying. Okay, I am no jelly plating expert, but let me make sure my camera's not going to fall over. All right, so like I said, I did a pull out and put in a notebook here. Papers that I've done different things on, jelly plating or just different. So this will be my brayer off book. Okay, so I'm going to set that right next to me here with some pages that I can flip open and brayer off. Let me get some things out of the way. Only so much room on the desk, you know. All right. These aren't all my stencils, but they're pretty much my favorite ones, and I just keep them in here, and they're well loved, well used, and when they get crunchy, they get glued down, right, Paula? I don't even know if Paula's still here, but anyway, so we'll just pull out whatever stencils come to mind or are handy, all right, and take it out of its little home. And I just leave the one side, I just leave the plastic on one side, peel off the other, and there we go. Okay. Maybe I'll put one of these I'll just get one of these at just to put something just to put it on something there. Okay, we're good. All right, now let me kind of line this up, get my camera straightened out. All right. Hey, Sharon. Still crooked. Hang on, guys. Look away if you get dizzy. All right, I think we're good. Looks pretty good. All right. All right, where's my brayer? What did I do? Hang on, I got to find my brayer. I only have one. Only got the one brayer. All right. So I got to even remember. what I'm going to do. Oh, all right. So I'm going to not use these two because that's got the dilutions ink on. I'm just going to set those aside. And so all my deli papers, and I'll do one with that is just not with no paint on it, just so you can see the difference with the paint. All right. So anyway, we ready, Freddie? Still crooked. There we go. There we go. All right. All right. You, go ahead, Cheeky. You're not going to miss anything. All right. So thanks, everybody. Well, we've been here 2 hours, so we've got probably about 45 minutes. It seems like Ustream stops lately at 2 hours, 45, 50 minutes sometimes. So we'll go either 45 more minutes or until it stops. So thanks everybody for being, oh, I wanted to do a giveaway. Hang on. Let's do a giveaway. I still have Packer dyes and wait, I got some of these too. Let's do this. I'll give, let's do, Jules got the, I mean, what do you call it? Oh, what's her name? Eileen. I still got a couple things here from Eileen. Some little envelopes. These little envelopes. I got this little Seven Gypsies. Oh, there's another envelope. These little Seven Gypsies book covers. I think, is there two in a pack in there? Yeah. Well, is it the front and the back? I think it's a front and back. Anyway, it's in a package. It's the whole package. I'll give that away. And then we have some Packer dye I still have some Packer Dye little ATCs. So I've been just kind of throwing these kind of things in my Happy Mail, but we'll do a specific giveaway. And she also has the little sleeves that they fit in. So we'll do that. So let's do one real quick. Let's do a giveaway. We'll give away one of these with a sleeve. Let's do this. There we go. So we'll give that away. Let's do two giveaways. Now the other giveaway, we'll have two of these, an envelope, two envelopes, however many's there, and two a Packer dies. There we go. So we'll do these today. We'll do two giveaways. How about that? So if you're here, thanks for sticking out with all the hour-long smack and drag. Whoops, hang on. Doing the smack and drag. Check my recording. Yeah, it's still recording. Yeah, we've been here 2 hours. Thanks, Jeannie, for reminding me. Okay, so we're going to do this one and this one. And let me get my post-it notes. Where are my post-it note blanks? Let me get another one out because I don't see it. I also have my lovely post-it notebook from JJ. Love it. Y'all saw that at my birthday. Let's see. I just want some plain post-it notes. Why can't I find any? Well, here's some flower ones. That'll work. All right, Sharpie. Okay, y'all know how it works. I'm gonna do it two times. I'm gonna give this one away and this little stack. This one has two of Packer Dye's ATCs, and this one has one, and then the little booklet from Eileen. All right, so I'm gonna write a number between, how many people are here? 1 and 50. I'm gonna write a number down between 1 and 50, and I'm gonna do it twice, one for each. And, you didn't see my book? Okay, Paula, I'll show it again. From JJ, I'll show that in 1 second. Paula goes, what was that awesomeness? JJ, if you're watching. Okay, so I'm going to write down a number between 1 and 50. When you see me type in the word go, write a number. Give me it one number only between 1 and 50. First person closest without going over. Carrie, can you help me? And, Carrie can, she'll stop the chat after the, so she does, from rolling off the screen. And then, so I make sure I don't miss anybody. And then I'll type in the word stop. Okay, so I'm going to write down a number between 1 and 50. Okay, and I know there's a lag, so I try to do it slowly. Slowly. Oh, I could easily run out of post-it notes. I go through a stack a week. I mean, look, I write down everything down post-it notes. Okay, so everybody just put in a number between 1 and 50. Closest without going over. First person closest without going over will get this. Eileen sent this in. She sent in these Packer Dye and her little ATCs. Okay. I'll just let it go, go, go. Sip a cold coffee. I need to go get some hot coffee. I'll just give it a second for everybody to have time to put their number in. And we're going to do it again for the second little giveaway. Okay. Okay, I don't see any more numbers being put in, so I'm going to type in stop. Okay, and the number was 28. And I saw a couple of 28s going by. I think I saw Bunny. Bunny was the first one I saw put in a 28. Am I right, Carrie? But now, Bunny, you'll need to email me your address. If you were, in fact, the winner, I will let Carrie double check for me, or anybody can double check for me. Bunny. Okay, so Bunny, if you will email me your address, which I do not give to anybody, your addresses are safe with me. Bunny, I will send you, here's my, Carrie, you'll probably have to retype it for me if I put it in. Okay. Now hello everybody else that's popped in. And anybody that wants to exchange addresses with me that's here, then just email me. Make sure you tell me your screen name though. Otherwise I won't know. Like if Bunny doesn't tell me her, it's Bunny, then I'm gonna go, who is this whatever person? Okay. Yeah. So Bunny C, if you will email me your address, I'll send this out to you and we'll do it again. Let me, I got a rubber band here somewhere. What did I do with my rubber bands here? So that will go to Bunny. And we'll do it one more time. Thanks, Carrie. If anybody else wants to grab my email, Carrie, just put it in for me. For, yeah. Okay, so we're going to do it again between 1 and 50 for a couple more Packer dye. Oh, I need to get a couple of those little black sleeves. And I got to show Paula my book here, too. Packer dye included the little holders. The little she gave you some black sleeves. Well, they're clear on one side, obviously, to keep the ATCs in, to keep them protected. All right. So, and then a couple of these little envelopes from Eileen, a couple little bags. So, we'll do that. All right. Y'all ready? Everybody, nothing's moving, so everybody must have a number picked. Okay, let me write down another number. Okay, I'll type in the word go. When you see it come up, then put in your number. I'll just give everybody a minute. Oh, well, while everybody's putting the number, let me show this book real quick. Paula, this is what I got for my birthday from JJ. She made me Dee Dee's book of post-its. And it's just a little journal, I mean a little chipboard book. And it's all different post-it notes. Every kind of post-it note you can imagine. Let me pull it down here. And they're chipboard pages. The pages are chipboard. Look, even that is post-it notes. So let me just flip real quick. All these are different post-it notes. Isn't that amazing? Isn't that so cool? All different. And look, see, that's a faux full clip. And then there's a speech bubble ones. I know. More speech bubble clouds, all just different kind of Paris ones. So yeah, JJ made that for my birthday. I know, isn't it adorable? I know, right? What a great idea. All different post-it notes. Okay, so somebody can double check, see who wants. It's 37. If someone wants to help me, Carrie or somebody, help me find who did 37. Or closest without going over. I don't know where she found all those post-it notes. She made the book. She made the book out of chipboard. You know, chipboard, it's got the grommets on the front and back and the little, it's all tied with a ribbon. Isn't that pretty? So I keep it right there with my post-it notes. Okay, Sandy. Okay, Sandy. Sandy Chick. Okay, Sandy Chick. Yay, Sandy Chick. You're going to get Packer Dye's little, another rubber band here somewhere. Packer Dye's little post-it notes. Feel the power. I mean, post-it notes. ATCs. And then lavish display. Look how colorful they are. I just love Packer Dye's stuff. All right, so let me put that on there and find a rubber band. So thanks everybody for hanging out today. So we'll get that out to you next week. All right. And Carrie, I got your stuff to send you too. And Jeannie, and you also some of that washi tape. And Carrie's squirrels. Yeah, I got a cut file. I bought this cut file for Carrie. And I cut it out in different sizes because she likes squirrel. Can you see the squirrels there? Isn't that so cute in the tree? The tree makes the heart and the roots. And there's little squirrels in there. So I cut out a big one and a bunch of little ones there. So that has to go out to Carrie too. All right, so there we go. Back to the jelly plating now. Yeah, so I'll get that all out, happy mail out this week. All right, so let's go ahead. These that have been white deli papers with a coat of white acrylic paint, and you could do gesso. Jean's probably already done it with gesso. She's probably napping now. Let's don't wake up Jean. Shh. Bye, Pam. Don't wake up Jean. Hi, Erica. You're welcome, Sandy. Okay, so let's see what colors we want to go with. Oh, my little blanky thing here on my chair just drives me crazy. All right, let's get some of the same kind of colors, maybe. The lime green, the turquoise, the pink, a red, all the bright colors that we like. We're going to go with the same ones that we've been using with the dilution, just because they're happy, bright colors. Maybe a little black. Let's see. And by the way, I did clean out, except for maybe a black and the white and a couple colors that are like right here and I use all the time. I cleaned out all the different ones. This one's a new one. I haven't opened it yet. But I picked out all the different little paint things in the closure and closed each one. And now I'm storing them this way so I can see the colors from the bottom. And they're all upside down. They look so pretty in their boxes. And plus, I can close them all. Now, just remembering to keep them closed. All right, let's see. Lime green, pink, what others? And red. Maybe an orange. Let's get a bright orange, maybe. And there's pumpkin. What other color? That's probably enough. Maybe yellow, maybe? Oh, the yellow doesn't show up very well. Maybe that's enough. We'll just start with this. I've only got like this many sheets of paper, so it's not like I got hundreds, right? Do you use it? I just buy the, now if you want to know any about different techniques on the silhouette, Jean is your go-to girl. She can make anything. I just buy the files pretty much. I mean, Jean sent me a few, her stencil designs and stuff like that, but pretty much I just buy them. I got them all on sale this last time. I think the sale is still going on at Silhouette, 50% off all the cut files. So yellow will be nice. All right, let me pick out a yellow here. I've got a bright yellow here. Let's see. There we go. All right. So what I'm going to do is we're just going to, let's start with some, and I usually put two colors to start. I'll put like teal, and let me open up this red because it's new here. Don't let Barb see me cutting this with a craft knife here. Shh, don't tell Barb. She's here, but don't tell her. She's here, but she's not here. I don't think she'll notice, right? Shh, don't tell her. So I'm going to just start with a couple colors in my brayer and get a little bit going here in some direction, one form or another. And then what I'll do, and I'm going to brayer off right over here on all my extra pages that are made just for this kind of thing. Then I'm just going to grab a stencil. That one's pretty rough. Paula, I think this one needs to get glued down somewhere, don't you think? Let's see what else I can find. Well, of course, y'all know I love my windows. Let's just go with one a bit of a window there, and then maybe some flowers, a little bit of flower here. Here's a piece that's ready to be glued down. Ho ho! Okay, and so I'm gonna giggle. The white, I don't think it really would matter so much which side, but I'll just go ahead and use the side that I painted on face down. Y'all have to go watch Paula's show from last night. Even though she had a little bit of a cold, and she's getting over it, she's feeling better. She was in rare form. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and use, and the reason again that I love deli paper because of the thinness, but I don't like it that it's not, that it's so translucent that the colors are not as vibrant. So I wanted to paint them white, at least, you know, a big swath of white, and to make them more vibrant. Okay, so here we go. So you can see how vibrant that is with the white on it. Okay, as compared to, I have one here with not painted white. So I'm going to pick up the stencils here. And let's see. Well, I don't know. Is there much there to get off? I never know if there's really a lot there. Or should I put another coat of something? I see, this is where I was like, oh, Jean, what do I do now? You know, kind of thing. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and take whatever's left here and go ahead and use that white again and pick up the residue. But on the next pull, the next one we do, I'm going to use a non-whited out paper so you can see the difference. hi, Vicki, and everybody else popping in. All right, so let's see what we got left off of that one. We can always reuse it again if it's not much. See, there's not much on there. So I'll just reuse this one again. Although it's cool, it's not bad. But all right, so let's go ahead. Now I'm going to do the same colors. I'm going to do the blue and the red just to compare. Okay, just to compare a non-painted page with a painted page. So you can see the difference with acrylic paint. All right, so again, I'm just going to put the red and the blue, or the teal rather. And a stencil. Let me clean this sprayer off. Let's see. Let's go. I'll go ahead and go again with that flower. And we'll go with, I got a little piece of something, something. What else? Let's go ahead and just cut off a piece of this. Because it's pretty much toast. So we'll just put a piece of that. Now what I'm going to do is use a page that has no paint on it. So you can see the difference in vibrancy between the white painted and the non-white painted. I mean, it's still cool. Don't get me wrong. Still cool with the deli paper, but it's just not as vibrant. Okay. All right. So here we go. So these are the same colors, but let's move it to the side a second here. So you can see the difference. There we go. Okay. So this has a white wash of acrylic paint dry on the deli paper. And this is just the straight deli paper. Okay. And this I love. This is okay, but I love the vibrancy of the paint coming through. Hey, Miko. Yeah, we're still here for a few more minutes. So there's the difference with a white painted background on the deli paper and no white paint on the deli paper. Yeah, it's really obvious, right? So we're going to go ahead and do the stack of painted white painted papers here. And let's see, I might just use some of my... Let me get to a blank sheet of paper over here where I can maybe clean these stencils. It's pretty much dry. I mean, there's not much left on these stencils by the time I wait this long to try to use them. Nothing's really coming off. Paula needs these. She needs to glue these down in a journal. I ought to make her glue these stencils in a journal, right, Paula? Right, Vern? Is this one safe to say we could use it in a mixed media project now? Okay, yeah, you're gonna see. Well, I'm not gonna do the differences. I'm just gonna do just the white ones here. All right, so and I'm gonna leave whatever's mess is on there with the next batch of color. All right, so now we're gonna I'm gonna put some pink. Let's put a little pink and a little lime green. And I'm leaving that red and turquoise there. It may or may not pick it up. I don't know. We'll have to ask Jean. Will that work, Jean? All right, so now I'm just gonna pull, you know, smooth out those two colors. Clean off my brayer. Let's see, let's go with, I got this window here, but we could maybe have it have some window panes in it. Then let's go ahead and put a little bit of edging on there. And then let's just put a little edging on this one too. All right, there we go. Again, I'm gonna use deli paper that's got a white coat of paint on it. Now, when you're using stencils, I do know this, you really want to get in all those grooves if you want to pick up the design. You really got to kind of mash it down well. And I like to use my fingers to kind of make sure I'm getting all the designs. I do know that much. I don't know a lot about deli paper. But, I mean, jelly plating, but that one. Oh, so it's okay if I use, okay, the paper ones are okay. It's just when we use the plastic ones and glue those in. Okay. Ho ho. I love you, Paula. All right, so here we go. All right, so it's got a little bit of design on there. Well, that's all that came through. Look how much I covered it with the stencil. So basically, I should probably not be putting that much stencilage on there, right? Because, you know, even when I pick this up, there's not going to be much there. Let me go ahead and use this sheet that I did a clean off. And we'll go see if I can pick anything up with that left over there too. So the less stencil, I probably need less stencil, not more stencil. Jean's probably just going saying, I'm staying out of this one today. Just don't get me involved. So again, I'm going to keep using this one to clean off with. All right, so but that's pretty. It's not a lot, but it is pretty, you know, right? Y'all think it's pretty? Rest in peace, Prima. Okay, so let's do some more. Let's do another pink and lime again, but not so much, just a little bit of stencilage. So we're getting more color on the pull. Okay. Go for it, Jean. Go for it, Edie. Go for it. All right. And see, there's all the techniques where you dry in between and all that, too. So there's all kinds of things. And Jean, I'm telling y'all, if y'all want a music scrapper, Music Scrap is the one to go see. Or Patty Tolly Parrish or... Carrie does some amazing things with the black paper, and there's tons of it out there. But I'm just talking about like the ones I know. don't look at me. I mean, seriously, I'm just, you know, I just know that I wanted more vibrant deli paper, so I painted them white. Okay, so let's see. There we go. Now we're cooking with a little white paint. So there's one with the white background, which see the difference between the non. So I really like that one. So that's a keeper. We'll set that one aside. We're going to keep adding things to the other ones. All right. Clean off that stencil a little. All right, let's go now with, a little black. Let's put a little black, just a dot here and there. Three little dots of black and some lime. And let's go with one little dauble of red there. Hey, Dixie, anybody else popping in? We're just, we're toward the end of the show. And see, I want to keep it. I don't want to get them, I don't want them muddy. I want them just like lots of color, like that. Okay. All right, let me get in my bag of goodies over here. Let's go with these letters. Let's go with some letters. They're all stuck together. Let's go with some letters. And then here on the edge, let's go. I have this little bit of grid from that Jean had cut me out a long time ago. All right, let's get, I'm going to go with this leftover. We're just going to go with that. See what we can pull up with that. So thanks everybody for being here. If the recording stops before we're done, well, thanks for being here. Okay, so that's kind of cool, isn't it? I like that. We all like this, I know. Because I know it's just the kind of thing we like. That, like, it looks like a hot mess to anybody else but our group. Everybody in our group's going to like this. But some splatters on these would be good, too. Let's go ahead and take this off. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a little bit of white paint out. Where's my... I just stuck my arm in there. Let me wipe that off. I really can brayer that one off. I think there's enough there to brayer off some of that excess paint on those numbers. Okay, then I'm going to kind of water down some of this white. And we're going to splatter some. Even though we're going to put it on white paper, it should still leave white. I mean, it should leave areas where the white is like shows through. We'll see. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm thinking it's going to like mask out the color where I hit it with the white splatter on the white paint. We'll see what happens. Okay, well, again, the white splatters really probably didn't do much, but I'm liking those colors. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go with some more lime green, red, and black. So I'm going to put a little more red, lime green, and black, and maybe a butterfly, and I don't know what else. I got some flowers here. We'll go with those. So just a dot of black. Where's the black? I'm just trying to use up these papers that I painted white this morning. And just kind of not over mixing, because wherever I don't have paint, wherever there's no paint, it's going to be white because I painted the background. All right, so let's go with, let's just go with all different kind of designs, a chevron, a circle, a little bit of a clock, a piece of something. Let's just go with that. And find which side I painted on. Yeah, they're all kind of graffiti-ish. Yeah. And I just like it because then you can use bits of it. You know, and you can add more to it. Could stencil more on top of it. Like maybe we'll do that with the next one, just to give it an example. See? That's cool, right? I think so. And then if there's anything left over, maybe I can just bop it off on there. There's really nothing coming off on those. You know? Pretty dried. Okay, so now again, let's just go with I don't even know. I'm just liking these colors. Hey, Rach, I'm liking the lime, the red, and the black. So we're going to keep going with that for a minute. So, and again, I'm just not over mixing them. I'm kind of just making it sort of all over, kind of spotty like. And because the paper's painted white, let me get to a clean sheet over here to gray it off. Because there's painted white. Oh, I want some kind of stencil. Let's just put this butterfly right smack in the middle. Does it matter when using the deli paper if you use it folded side up or down? Not to me. They're pretty much, after I've painted them white, I pretty much that fold is gone. After I painted them white, like here, here's one that I've just nothing. Look, you don't even see the fold anymore. And because I'm going to use it in collage and stuff and tear it up, cut it up, glue it on something else, again, you know, that's not going to matter to me. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Pretty cool. We'll keep that one. We'll keep this one. Pick up this butterfly. And let's go with some new colors now. Let's go with yellow. And whatever's left. Just go ahead and go with the yellow and whatever's left. Yeah, it's going to need something else. Let's go with some, let's just add a little drop of pink. And maybe a drop of black. And I really like the way those letters looked on there. Go with the letters again. Let's just go with some more of that. Like I said, I'm doing this because I love the deli paper, but it's never vibrant enough for me. But with the white paint behind it, ooh, I see, I really love that. We're going to do some more of that. Let's do some more with this jeans cutout stencil. Well, let me see if I can get anything pulled up with this. Let me use... let's see if I can pull any of that leftover up. If not, we'll just reuse this particular sheet. Well, it pulled up some good, pretty good stuff. I'm going to use this particular sheet again. We're going to go ahead and do the same colors, pink, red, black, and yellow. So let's go with yellow first, then a little pink. Just a dab of those colors. One little dab of red. Then we'll add some black after we mix these on here. Then we're going to use that. Okay. All right. I'm not looking at chat much. Alright, I want to use this again. I'm really liking this fancy looking thing. Alright, now I'm going to go ahead and use this sheet again. Let's just go ahead and add that on top and see what else we get. You like that one? I don't even know which one you like. By the time I see, oh, I really like that one. I'm probably five sheets. I was going to say five sheets to the wind, but... There we go. Sweet. All right, set that one aside. And let's pick up the stencil. And let's see what we can pick up with this. Leftover. And again, this was just an experiment with painting the pages white so the vibrancy of the colors doesn't get lost on the deli paper. And that's a cool one too. Look at some of those little areas. That would be cool to cut out. All right, let's go with some different colors. I need a dark blue. No, well, let's just see. Whoa, come back here. Some orange. Come on. Okay. That's kind of a lot. Where's another green? Go with a dark green. We know Jean loves it. That'll wake Jean up. All right, a little green and maybe a little lime in there. Let's go with those three. Then we can always add a little something else. All right, let's see here. So I got way too much paint on this one. All right, what other stencils do I want? Let's go with this clock, a little edge of chevron, and some flowers. It's all going to get cut up, so it doesn't really matter as far as, like, it doesn't have to be an exact pattern all over or whatever. I know, Jean, I'm just teasing you. Jean, I know you like to nap in my show. That's perfectly fine with me. You work so hard. I'm surprised you don't nap in more shows. All right, let's see what this is. Ooh, now that is pretty cool. See where the white shows through? Is that Jean? All right, let's take these off. Let's see what we got left on here. Let's go with this little bit of window here. Let's just pick up whatever we got left with that. You nap in everyone's show? Okay. You're an equal opportunity napper, Jean. There we go. There, we're getting somewhere with this one now. Right? See, but what would be cool is just imagine some script on that. You know? Some writing, some inking, some calligraphy. This would be cool to do calligraphy on. I'll have to let it, maybe if we have time. Well, I don't know. We got probably about 20 minutes. And I wanted to finish all these, but these would be good just to write some calligraphy on. We'll see if we have time. All right, let's go. Who keeps, I'm not sure who's tweeting me. We don't have time to tweet. We don't have time to tweet right now. Let's go with some dark green and some pink. With the white background, remember? All right, let's see if I can find another stencil. I should have done that first. Oh, here, let's go with this. Look at all my poor stencils. Let's go with this one. Right across there. Got all these little bits. Let's just throw those in there too. What the heck, right? Okay. If you put that down in a journal, does the deli paper melt? Not as much. It doesn't like fade away as much as tissue paper, like if you stamped on it and stuff. It's more, because it's more waxy. It does, it's not as, thin, you know, as tissue paper. And of course, that's going to depend on the tissue paper too. Carrie knows how to do good stamping on tissue paper. Okay, let's see. All right, so there's that. But it just needs more. You know what I mean, Vern? So, like, let's just go ahead and pick up whatever's left over there just to pick it up. You know, it's not a lot. but there's some. Oh, let's see. Let's go with a little bit of yellow and orange. And we'll just start with that. Let's just get that spread out. And then add on, let's see, let's add in a little bit of red, just a dot here and there. And maybe just one little dollop of black. Don't even want much, just a tiny, tiny bit. Just to give it a little. All right, I'm going to go back to the letters again. I'm really liking the letters. We'll put that right smack down the middle. And I don't know, just the edge of some butterfly wings just to give it a design on the side there. All right. Now I'm going to go ahead and use this paper. It's already got some stuff on it. So that'll make it more like a mess. Well, you can just use your own handwriting. You don't have to do like lettering calligraphy. And I know, and I don't have it, but Joanne Sharp has a book out on lettering. You could just do lettering. It doesn't have to necessarily be calligraphy. All right, let's see what we got here. Again, see, that's pretty cool, right? All right, let's pick this up. Maybe I can get a little bit mashed up on a side paper there. All right, now let's see what we can do with this. Let's go ahead and put some white on there just to see if we can pick some of that up with the white paper. Let's just see what happens. I'm just going to keep going, guys, until the time runs out. Wax paper, I mean, to me, it's just not the same as deli paper. You want me to do one with wax paper? I can do one. Again, it's not going to be, it's not painted white. It's not going to be as vibrant. All right, so we got it kind of, I'd say that's a good background. Now let's go in with some teal and some black. I'm just making it up, guys. I don't know. You know, whatever color you like. Oh, I picked up green. That wasn't black. Okay, we're going to roll with it. And then let's go with, let me pick something else out. Let's just go with some dots here. Now let's go with the spider web right in the middle. Let's just take that spider web and plant it right in the middle. I'm going to just take this paper. And we're going to go with that. Yeah, the thing about the deli paper is it gets in the designs. It's so thin, you know, it gets right into those creases of a stencil. All right, there we go. That's a nice big spider web. Linda. Then all we need is this, like, where's a, don't have any blank, where's a, we just need, don't, if anybody creeps out about spiders, don't yell, just hang loose. Let's go ahead and take this white paint. Let's put a couple little in here. Then let's find a, you just put a little spider there. Okay, next. Let's remove that. My poor stencils. And let's see, I'm really going to just keep this one like it is. I like that one. I want to, let's go ahead and see if I can pick up any leftover green on this one. Hey, Linda, I didn't even know you were here. All right, it picked up a little more. All right, let's see what else. Now, let's do some, like the black, white, and one color, like we did with the other, the inks. All right, so let's just do a little black and white first. Now, the white is going to either turn gray here, or it won't, you know, it'll get like a partial mask on the white paper. And then we'll go with just a little bit of teal, so I can see a little bit on there. I'm running out of time here. So, there. And let's see what other stencil do I want. Okay, I got this piece of a flower. And I got a little bit crunch. That's almost nothing there left. Let's go again with the butterfly right there. I'm just going to go with this piece of paper. It's already got stuff on it. Let's just see what happens. Because it's just like for the designs for me. I'm wanting a whole bunch of just like odd designs to use. Linda's got something coming to her. She's already got something wrapped up and mailed. So her book that Paula told me to send to her. Okay, so there we go. That's pretty cool, right? It's just like layering. All right, next, let's take these off. Let's go with some more black, maybe, and white again, just a little. Let's just go with a little black and a little blue. Let's just go here. So I want some of the white to show, you know, the white of the paper. All right, so there's that. Now let me get another spot here. Let's see what else I got in the bag of tricks. All right, let's go with this. No, that covers up too much. Here's this window. It doesn't cover up as much. Let's go with that window. And let's go with the letters again at the bottom. Upside down, right side up. Let's just go with that. And let's go with this. So yeah, we're at 2 hours and 50 minutes. So I'm assuming Ustream is going to shut off pretty soon. So thanks everybody for being here. I still plan on doing my regular stream tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. Eastern. If y'all are not in, I don't call it a member or whatever. If you're not signed up on my Ustream, sign up. And then sometimes you'll get an email alert when I go live. I think that depends on your server, actually. All right, so there we go. That's interesting. Cool, right? See the letters? Just those little bit of letters showing through just makes it a little more interesting. Let me go ahead and turn this over and see if I can pick up any leftover paint there off those letters so that I can use this again. Not much. We'll just put it down again. All right, so let's do black, white, and lime green with a little bit of whatever teal is left on here. Okay, so I'm going to go with the black, the white, just a tiny bit because the white of the paper is going to pick that up. Okay. Find a brayer, place to brayer off. And some lime green. And let's see, I'm going to go with the letters again, just because I'm liking them. Where are they? We'll go with some letters straight across the middle. Maybe this little bit of square again. and the edge of the butterfly. And we're going to just, I got this piece. It's got a little bit of something on it. Let's just go with that. And we're just kind of reusing the same papers over and over because that just makes more interesting textures. My camera's okay. I have a nice HD camera if I want to do just straight YouTubes, but it's not a webcam. You know, it's just a regular, you know, the kind of camera that you would do videos with. My webcam is a Logitech C930E. And at the time, it was the newest Logitech, and it's been like maybe going on maybe 2 years with this one. So they may even have another one out. The thing is, when you're watching these recordings on Ustream or YouTube, is we don't have HD on unless you pay on Ustream. So even if you have an HD camera, your quality is still not HD quality because we only get medium. They have low, medium, and high quality. You don't get to anymore. You used to. You don't get the high quality unless you pay for it. So that's why we stream on medium. Okay, so there we go. That's pretty cool. It needs more color. So I think what I'm going to do is I will add some lime green to this. Just a little bit of lime green here and there. Not cover the whole thing, but just put a little bit of lime green here and there like that. And then go back a little sideways with it. You just pick up that lime green a little bit and just give it some more texture. Okay, so it stopped recording, guys. Okay, I'm just going to continue recording for 30 seconds to let y'all know that my recording stopped. So thanks everybody for being here. I'm going to stay here and finish this up, but I'm not going to record it. So thanks everybody for being here, and I'll see you Monday morning, 9 a.m. Eastern. Bye.